I'm here today in my loofah tunnel to share with you my best tips for growing loofah. Loofah is one of the most fun things you can grow. Growing loofah requires a lot of sun, a lot of room, and a lot of time. But if you have all three of those things, give growing loofah a try. If we haven't met before, my name's Angela from Growing in the Garden, and I love to share garden inspiration and helpful tips so you can be successful growing your own garden. If you're like me, you may have thought that loofah sponges came from the sea. Boy, was I wrong. When I saw them growing at the county extension office here when I was taking my master gardener classes, I was shocked. You're telling me that a sponge comes from a plant? I had no idea. Loofah has also been called dishcloth gourd or a vegetable sponge. No matter what you call it, this vegetable is actually a type of summer squash. It's grown a lot like a winter squash because the vines get so large, but you plant it at the same time as you would plant other summer squash, which means you plant it in the spring after danger of frost has passed and the temperatures have warmed a bit. It definitely doesn't like it too cool. To eat loofah as a vegetable, you have to catch it when it's very young, around 6 inches long. If you let it get any longer than that, then the insides are already becoming fibrous and it gets really tough to eat. But most people grow loofah for the sponge inside. Loofahs can grow up to 2 feet long. Growing loofah can take a lot of time and patience. If your growing season isn't quite that long, consider starting loofah seeds inside and then transplanting them outside. But if you're like me here in the low desert of Arizona, we have a nice, long, warm growing season, and those loofah seeds do great started directly in the soil. Choose an area to plant loofah seeds that get plenty of sunlight. Loofah loves the sun. Yes, even direct full Arizona sun. These loofah gourds have been growing in full sun all summer long and they have been so happy. If you live in a cooler area, pick the warmest spot in your yard to grow loofah. A western exposure or next to a block wall that might radiate some heat would be a good choice for growing loofah in a cooler climate. Zone 6 is about the limit for growing loofah. If you're growing in zone 6, start those seeds indoors to give them a nice jump on the growing season. If you've watched any of my other videos, you know I'm a big fan of square foot gardening. So if you're doing square foot gardening, plant 2 or 3 loofah seeds per square. Loofah seeds can take a little while to germinate, so be patient while you're waiting for those sprouts to appear. One of the most important things you can do when growing loofah is make sure to give the loofah vines something to climb. This trellis is 8 feet tall and 18 feet long, and the loofah has covered the entire trellis. The loofah vine will grow for what seems like forever before you see any flowers. After a while, you'll begin to see beautiful yellow flowers. Those are probably the male flowers. Beautiful yellow flowers that the bees love. Your vine will be covered in bees and in flowers. But the female loofah flowers take a little bit longer to appear, so be patient. Watch those male flowers and eventually you'll see what looks like a miniature loofah with a flower on the end. And that is a female flower. That's what you've been waiting for. Hopefully there are plenty of bees and they're going to take care of transferring the pollen from the male flower to the female flower. But if you don't want to take any chances, or if you're seeing female flowers becoming withered and not being pollinated, take matters into your own hands and transfer the male pollen to the female blossom. Once pollinated, that female blossom is what is going to grow and develop into the loofah gourd. I have more than 42 loofahs growing in this tunnel, and for a while I was really wondering if I was ever going to see any females, but they showed up, and they showed up big time. Don't cut back the vines if possible, because those growing leaves and the vines are what are supplying energy to make your loofah gourds grow large. So let those vines grow and get a little crazy, and they're gonna provide a lot of energy so you can have nice, big, fat loofah gourds. Pretty soon you're gonna be wondering, what is the best time to harvest my loofah gourds? This is where a long growing season is so important. If frost is threatening, frost will damage and destroy the loofah vines, and it may cause the fruits to rot. So if frost is threatening, you may have to harvest those loofahs either before or just after that frost. Those loofahs that had to be harvested a little early may or may not ripen, but it's worth giving them a try. Hang them up and allow them to ripen indoors outside of the frost. And once those skins shrivel, you'll be able to see if it was on the vine long enough. In order to produce the maximum amount of that fibrous flesh, you want to leave your loofahs on the vine as long as possible. And that's where living in some place like the low desert of Arizona comes in handy, because we do have a very long growing season. So I'm going to allow these to ripen on the vine. Here's what to look for before you harvest. The skins are going to change from a green to a more yellow color, and the loofah is actually going to get lighter. As the insides become more fibrous and dry out, and the skin begins to shrivel and turn yellow. The nice thing about growing loofah is you learn from experience when those loofahs are ripe. As you grow, you'll be able to feel the loofah and feel the inside and feel the outside, and you'll be able to tell when it's time to harvest and when the best time to peel that would be. It's best to peel at the stage when it's lightweight and the skin begins to shrivel and turn yellow. If the skin feels loose and thin, like it will come off easily, then it's ready. I like to peel my loofah before it gets completely hard and dry. Sometimes the insides will get brittle if you wait and leave it on too long. If your loofah is still very green, it should probably be left on the vine a little bit longer. You can see this loofah is starting to get to be a lighter color, and it's feeling a little bit more lightweight, but it still has a while to go. These loofahs are still growing. You can see the difference in color here. This one is still pretty dark green and pretty heavy. This one is a little bit lighter color. A great way to tell is the skin begins to loosen. You can hear this, the pliability of this skin, and how loose you can feel the sponge inside. So this one is definitely ready. This one looks similar in color, but is still really hard. So that skin hasn't loosened at all, so it is not quite ready. This is another example of one that's ready. When I push it, you can feel that skin has separated. Nice big sponge inside. Use your thumbs to find a loose spot along a seam. Push in to create a tear, and then pull apart the skin and tear up the seam. When the loofah is fully ripe, it comes out easily. If not, you may have to roll it around a little bit to help it loosen from the inside of the skin. So if your pods are dry or have really brittle skin and they're not peeling very well, you can go ahead and soak those pods in water, and they will be a little bit easier to peel. The fun thing about growing loofah is you can also grow next year's loofah seeds. Loofah seeds are ready when they turn a nice deep black. To harvest the seeds, snip off the end of the loofah plant and simply shake out the seeds. To remove the seeds from a previously peeled loofah, just allow the loofah to dry and then shake out the seeds. Let the loofah dry completely in the sun to prevent mold. Wondering how to use your harvested loofah? Here are a few ideas. Use harvested loofah any way that you would use a normal sponge. Use it for cleaning, in the kitchen, in the shower. Loofah is a natural product, and bacteria can build up inside the loofah. So let it dry out completely between uses, and that will help prevent that. Loofah will keep and can be stored for several years if you keep it in a cool, dry place. Don't store it in plastic. I store my extra loofah in a paper sack, and that works just fine. Just keep the dust off of it and keep it dry, and loofah will store for years. Those are my best tips for growing loofah. If you have the room and the sunlight, give growing loofah a try. It is such a fun crop to grow, harvest, and use. Thank you so much for watching.